Now let's run away from history, even it was very interesting and full information. Professor Mohammed, also from Egypt, will come with his speech, with his paper about evidence-based medicine and copying. So what is nowadays?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I think it's very difficult to give a speech after Dr. Reda. Dr. Reda, mashallah, is a very fluent, amazing lecturer. First, it's my honor really to be here in Bosnia. This is my second time, and I love Bosnia. I love Bosnian people. I think Bosnia not only a lovely place, but it is a spiritual place. I don't know how and why, but this is the fact I feel it. And I thank my brother, Dr. Merim, who has done a great effort to host this conference. I think that the topic I will touch is one of the most important topics. We live in the environment, atmosphere of evidence-based medicine, evidence-based practice. The Western country does not know except evidence-based medicine. Hijama is many times attacked because there is no big evidence in about hijama practice. And I think this, inshallah, will be one of the most important recommendations after this conference to initiate and potentiate academic and researchers to have well-designed multi-centric research studies in hijama. Actually, I'm a senior professor in Cairo University. I'm a professor since 20 years, full professor, but I'm just junior practitioner in hijama, learning from Dr. Suleiman, from Dr. Merim, from Dr. Hussein. But later on, I think, okay, thank you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I have nothing commercial to disclose. My lecture will answer, I will try to answer two questions. Is hijama an effective modality of healthcare, or it is a pseudo medicine, it is a fake? And the second question, what are the specific healthcare conditions which hijama may improve? These pictures, we are familiar to this picture, especially after what you call international programs, international competition for athletes. This is the famous pyramid hierarchy of evidence-based. In the bottom, ideas, opinion, expert opinions, comments, and at the top, researches, especially if randomized, controlled, double blind. In my opinion, touching evidence for hijama is something peculiar, something different. History will give evidence. Dr. Reda already gave an amazing lecture about history. Where hijama is practiced is an indirect evidence. Athletes is an evidence in themselves. Then patients and doctors, testimonials is an evidence. And the last but not least, what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. And of course, the researches and studies. So is hijama an effective health modality? History, what history will say? History simply will say that along long years in different places, people were convinced with hijama. They have seen by their eyes results. If the results were not satisfactory, sure, they will not complete practicing hijama. Where Egypt, he mentioned this, East China, Mongolia, Arabs in different ways. So I think this is a very solid evidence in my opinion. The second one, hijama is practiced all over the world. In Canada, in China, in Germany, in Saudi Arabia, in France, in USA, in Turkey, in Arab Emirates, in Bosnia. All of these countries, I think, there is some sort of a strong health authority putting regulation, following practice, and if they will see pseudo medicine non-effective modality, sure they will abandon this, they will stop this. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the belief of all Muslims, his guidance is true and it is beyond doubt. His guidance does not need proof. His guidance is in itself a strong evidence. So many narrations, if there is, can I move this? Meaning, if there is anything good in the medicine with which you treat yourself, is incision or scarification, it's better translation of hijama and a drink of honey and cauterization. And this is in Sahih Muslim. And also another narration in a cupping is a cure. Abdullah ibn Abbas reported that Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had cupping for headache. Most probably it was a migraine. And he had a unilateral hijama for what we call thigh pain and ankle pain. What are the health condition which will be most likely to be improved by hijama? I'm coming after one or two slides to research some researchers and the studies. Most of the studies said that it's about well-being, improve well-being, boost energy, improve mood, and treat many, many painful conditions and non-painful conditions. The athletes, it is not uncommon to see many pictures like this. This picture was got from the internet about the Algerian national team of football during preparation for one of their international fights. This man, he is a lifter of what you call it. Yes, heavy lifter, and he had at least to improve his performance. This is the international champion of swimming. He, before any competition, he used to make this. What does this mean? Athletes look for better wellness, better energy, better performance, less pain during the competition, and less spasm. Usually they have dry, not wet, most of them. And the evidence here is that these international champions are supported by medical team. The medical teams will see that this modality is not effective, it will lose time and their health, sure, they will stop this. What about, not the core of my lecture, but this important part, the research studies and documents. This link, there are many researchers in this paper. 2010, a Chinese team revised the quality and quantity of many randomized control study. And he said that in the last 50 years, there is much improvement of these studies, and he showed the potential benefit on pain condition, herpes zoster, and other disease. But they recommend rigorous design trials for the next years. This was the title of this research, clinical research evidence of cupping therapy in China. Systematic literature review. In 2021, an Indian team published this. I'm sorry, the bar is obstructing the name, so just I'm trying. Evidence-based therapeutic benefits of cupping therapy, a comprehensive review. They conclude that hijama plays an important role in maintaining normal health, beneficial in both preventive and curative regime. Hijama is used effectively for the management of musculoskeletal, reproductive, and nervous disorders. I don't know. It is not moving. Thank you. And a third Korean team tackling the same thing, their paper evidence map of cupping therapy. Actually, they reviewed 13 systematic reviews, and they stated that hijama there had potential effects in low back pain, including spondylitis, knee osteoarthritis, neck pain, herpes zoster, migraine, psoriasis, and chronic urticaria. And same, they recommend that to have. I think because it is your laptop, so no one will touch it. Except you. So it's a Bosnian. And this is what the Korean team. This picture, this is a herpes zoster, what you call lesion. And me, myself, with my very limited experience, I have seen miracles after applying. Really, I have done three cases. The three patients immediately after finishing my session had got a relief of pain. Now I'll try to make some zoom in on some researches talking about some specific cupping therapy for migraine. This analysis of randomized control studies, 2021, it was published in the journal Evidence-Based Complement Alternative Medicine. And actually, same conclusion, it is effective with potential significant effect, but needs more and more what you call randomized or well-designed control study. And here is the reference. I will talk about this Malaysian Ministry of Health document in the next few slides. They studied about 45 studies, and they put inclusion criteria. They got some comments and some conclusions. They look for low back pain, and they defined the non-specific low back pain which hijama will be effective as non-specific low back pain is defined as low back pain not attributable to a recognizable known specific pathology like tumor, osteoporosis, lumbar spine, fracture, deformity, inflammatory disorder, or radicular syndrome. I know that my brother, Dr. Merrim, will differ with me because he thinks that hijama is effective in all of these conditions. Am I right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And the back, I mean the neck pain. Yesterday, Dr. Sulaiman was talking about this study. They are starting this study in Istanbul, in one of the famous complementary medicine centers there. The patient, there were 40 patients complaining of fibromyalgia, and the preliminary results that all of them improved after three sessions. So the painful condition, the non-specific low back pain, neck pain, migraine, severe head pain. There are many, but I'm just stressing two or three non-specific because these Malaysian studies conclude, thank you, this Malaysian study concluded that the lipid profile will improve and the what you call, this is another study from Saudi Arabia about quality of life in chronic diseases. A third one from Egypt, Zagazig University, talking about diabetes type 2. So three non-painful condition are significantly in many, many studies are improved by hijama. So the final document of the Malaysian, I want to make. The importance of this Malaysian document, it is released from the Ministry of Health after on it's a recent study 2019, nearly about 50 papers were revised, and they came to a very important conclusion. I will consider it as my final conclusion. There was a fair level of retrievable evidence to suggest that the usage of wet cupping as a single treatment or in combination with conventional or modern therapeutic modalities seemed to be effective and provided added value compared to conventional therapy or medication or no treatment, particularly in a pain-related condition as non-specific low back pain, neck pain, migraine, headache, herpes, knee osteoarthritis, and were able to reduce serum levels. And they said that in diabetes type 2, it is also effective in patients. I think I have time. So Engineer Mahmoud, can you just run one of the videos, because we will have one or two videos from two of my patients just as another source of patient. Sorry.
Sure.
Okay. Engineer Mahmoud, you are ready?
Yes. الحقيقة وافقت الدكتور محمد ان هو نعمل جلسة حجامة وخدنا معاد، وفي اليوم ده انا قررت اني ما اخدش العلاج عشان اشوف الاثر بتاع الحجامة بحيث ان هو ما يكونش فيه confusion في ما بين اثر الدواء. الدكتور محمد راح لي الحجامة على ظهري، على الليجنز اللي في ظهري الاول. كان الريسبونس يعني بالنسبه لي غريب جدا.
باللغه العربيه
بعد ما خلصت
بعد اذنك. اوكي، اكشلي this was a doctor having post herpetic pain neuralgia. Before making a session of hijama for him, I consulted my senior in hijama. I talked to Dr. Merim and Dr. Sulaiman and Dr. Hussein, and I went for it. Actually, when I finished the session, this doctor was suffering from severe pain for 1 month. And he, because he's a doctor, started by paracetamol, non-steroids, up to narcotics sometimes. And thanks God, after finishing the session, all the pain gone. Okay. So my conclusion is hijama is an effective modality in many health conditions, especially painful condition, although there is an increasing number of studies in the field of hijama the last 15 years. However, rigorous, well-designed studies are lacking to support hijama applications in all different health conditions. This is my picture. I had sinusitis, and again, I consulted my senior to make or not to make, and I let my daughter, actually, she experienced it to make this for me. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Professor Mohammed, our dear guest, Professor Mohammed Wills, is professor in Cairo University, and thanks to him, we get insight in new researchers in hijama. We start from history, and now, don't please excuse us for technical problems. We are simple doctors.